For each of us here today, our social fabric is intimately tied to the design of our urban public spaces, streets, and sidewalks. The design of our communities influences how we interact, travel, recreate, and just live on a day-to-day basis. But sadly, in North America, car-centric urban design has isolated people from public space. Next time you're on a busy urban street, take a look around you. You'll see, we're designing our cities for cars, not for people. And this is isolating, especially for people who cannot or do not drive due to income, age, mobility, or other intersectional factors. However, it is not just the design of our cities that can be critiqued, but also the urban planning processes that result in these designs. Current planning practices do not consistently engage all residents in the process of designing their communities from start to finish, which of course results in public spaces that prioritize certain populations and modes of transportation while marginalizing and excluding others. But it doesn't have to be this way. My thesis looks at how inclusive planning processes can actually be a pathway to the creation of healthy public spaces that support diverse and mixed uses. I use an embedded community-based research approach to do this. I work with a project called Active Neighbourhoods Canada, which engages residents of Peterborough Stewart Street neighborhood. In this project, neighborhood residents, community organizations, the university, and the municipality are working together to create opportunities for people to contribute to urban design. We use some more traditional engagement methods like public forums and surveys, but we also use some more unique ones like piloting pop-up bike lanes or mapping neighborhood assets on a 3D community model. And my research specifically evaluates this project approach and looks at the feasibility of scaling it up. So I've conducted focus groups with project participants, neighborhood residents, and professional planners. And my evaluation finds that this approach is effective. Project activities rank quite high for criteria related both to the project process and its outcomes. Next, I'm working with city staff people to determine the feasibility of implementing this approach more broadly in the city. The ultimate goal of my research is to see urban planning become an accessible and participatory process that supports the creation of healthy and vibrant public spaces so that people of all ages and abilities can travel actively, resident safety is enhanced, and a sense of pride and inclusion is fostered within the community. Thank you.